We have with us Mr. Prakash Raj, multi-talented, multi-linguist, one of the top most heroes or can say a very good actor in the Hindi cinema as well as South cinema. And today from real life, he's coming to real life politician. So, you are here in Bangalore to contest the forthcoming Lok Sabha elections. What made you to come here?
I don't come, they brought me here. The situation brings me here. It's an organic growth. To see where the country is heading, to see that we have lost sensitivity, to see when a country is voting with fear, not knowing, and seeing leaders, seeing political parties which have become the kings and rulers, I realized that I need to be a voice of the citizen and I need to represent the voice of the citizen in parliament, and we start choosing right.
Why Bangalore?
Bangalore is where I am born. Bangalore where I have lived. Bangalore is where I have derived. From Bangalore is where I took off. And Bangalore, whatever I have achieved, whatever perceptions, whatever qualities I have, has been chiseled in Bangalore, has been empowered by Bangalore, have been strengthened by my roots. So I think you come back to the roots and start a new journey again, all over again, from Bangalore.
The present political scenario, what have you to say about that?
The present political scenario, you see, you don't see, you see that we are in a denial mode that of national parties, of somebody moving from one particular point. No, we have a varied culture, varied representation, varied languages, and we need to be collective. Collective thought process need to come in. I think a sort of federal thought process needs to come in, and we need to realize that, get back the spirit of the constitution, which basically was that you find a leader for your constituency and they come together, a group of 500 plus, and decide the prime minister and decide, come in consensus and rule the country. Now it is not that way at all.
But today's politics has become polarization politics.
Okay. So what do you want me to do? Shouldn't we start changing it back?
Yeah. So do you think, where are we heading?
We are not heading anywhere. Every time a chaos comes, it's a natural process that again nature comes back, human spirit to strive, to evolve, is a part of evolution, that we always get into a cycle and then we come back. We get into a rut and we come back. And what I see in India is that spirit of soaring which has to upkeep the humanity, which has to upkeep the inclusiveness, which is the only way a society, a nature, or a life continues. I think the need for it has arisen, and today's political scenario has led to people to realize it is in them to revive it back to glory.
I think a lot of political parties must have approached you to be a part of their system.
And it happens.
Why are you going independent?
It happens. Political parties or political groups or any particular forces which are on the decline will try to hang on to you and to survive, and I have decided no, when you are going, go.
And do you think that today's type of politics is different from what it was yesterday and years before? What difference have you seen in so many years?
There was no longer any growth here. No, we start for the development and now we see polarization. Where is this? I never knew that Amir Khan was a Muslim. I never knew Vijay was a Christian. I never looked at it that way. Who is this particular thought process? Please look at this country where you see a BJP or right-wing actors. All Hindus don't want Muslims or minorities out. They don't hate one another. But then who has given them the fear that if the minorities come, they will be perished and they vote in fear. And you have another party, parallel party, which says that if these people come up, you will be perishing. So you vote. The whole country, there is a national disease called fear in this country, and there is a national disease called cynicism in this country. When they keep telling us, no, we can't do it, how do we change, we have to adjust and go. Then time has come for survival, to come back to life, to add more zest into life. We need to fight these two things.
You have seen most of the politicians who are contesting today are not educated, they have got criminal background. Do you think it's high time we bring in a change where educated person stand, and voter also is quite educated to vote, because most of the high class, the rich class, people are staying in the apartment, don't come to vote. So how will you fight the system?
You have an answer. High class. The way you have questioned, You know it is right and you have an answer already. Yeah, and I would like to ask those people and tell those people to take responsibility who have not voted. In a city like Central, in a constituency Central, 52% or 55% votes. And what are you 45% doing? You should take responsibility for the slums to happen there. You are responsible for the wrong leaders to come in. 45% who don't vote don't want this leader. 30% of them have not voted for this. And you have led us to a space where 75% don't want this as a leader and he's ruling. And 45% who have not voted, I think you should realize you have no moral or ethical right to ask for good roads, good governance, because you are not in the process of deciding who should lead you.
Nowadays politicians, you know, after once they have been an election, horse trading takes place. Now you know what's happening in Karnataka Assembly. So
don't ask me, do I know? You also know.
No,
all of us know.
Everybody knows. I mean, how do you correct the system?
Elect.
Correct.
Elect the right leader.
Money plays an important role.
Arre, why should it play an important role? Elect the right leader. Decide, choose, see the candidates, make a choice. If you don't do, this is what is going to happen. When will you learn your lessons?
Sir, now that you are contesting independently, many people have come, like Aam Aadmi Party and many people. Do you think that the force is, you know, pushing you to really come up and, you know, do something? People are, you know, waiting that Mr. Prakash Raj was a top Hindi and a villain and he has done so many good roles. Will you do something for us? What is your agenda? What is your...
How dare you say I am a top villain who will do something to this country? How dare you look at me as an actor?
Actor.
How dare you do? I am a citizen. If a doctor can become a politician, if an engineer can become a politician, but not an actor. Look at me, not because of my acting prowess. Look at me, what have I got to offer? Look at me, is he thinking of change? He is a citizen too. Don't polarize it. That's one thing. So you need to look at things like that.
How will you bring these changes, sir?
How will you bring this thing? Am I talking to you or not?
Yeah.
Am I not talking about the issues of this country? Am I not questioning you that why you are not thinking? Bring in all the candidates. See, don't vote for a party, vote for a candidate. Vote to somebody who has the courage to stand up for the society needs.
Will you take any party support if they come forward, like the Congress?
Let all islands come together, will become a nation.
Nation.
If there is somebody secular, who is not egoistic, who doesn't want to build his brand, but he sees a better candidate in me. Like Aam Aadmi Party has come, BSP is coming, KRS has, KTR has come. A lot of people, all of the organizations have come, the people who are fighting for citizens' rights have come. Why are they coming? Why are they coming? Because they now realize that we need to come together. We people who think secular have become islands. Islands don't survive. Let's come together. Let's start a movement. Let's create an ambience in this country that any right-thinking, a man with a vision, can stand for elections, can plead for a position that he will lead you from the front.
Your message?
If I have to give a message, I'll send an SMS. What will I do?
No, to the voters here.
To my dear voters, I request you, before you vote for me or to anybody else, think. Think what we are going through. Think as a nation where we are heading. Think that we are responsible for it too. Think responsibly, vote responsibly. It's our future.
We hope whatever message you are giving the voters, this time at least elect the right person. It's only time will tell. Mr. Prakash Raj will be your MP and will be the voice of the people of Karnataka. This is one for Nashaman News, Bangalore.